Hello everyone, today I'm going to start a project in Tableau regarding data management. So let's begin. So after opening the Tableau software, we have to insert the data. Now there are various formats through which you can, you know, insert the data into the Tableau software. You can see we have database of SQL, Oracle, Amazon, and we have PDF files, JSON files, whereas we regularly use Excel sheets. So I'll explain you with the help of data sheet. So we have a data base in the name of student data. We'll open it and extract the data into Tableau. So you can see after, you know, inserting the data inside Tableau, it is showing the number of sheets which are present on that particular Excel sheet. The first one is main, the second one is temporary. So I am taking the main sheet, double clicking, it will import all the data inside the Tableau. So you have seen the data is imported inside and the number of rows which are present is 1000. So one key factor which I want to highlight over here that while inserting data into the Tableau, sometimes the default setting takes only 1000 rows, but there may be chances that in your present sheet or in the real Excel sheet, there may be more number of data and the more number of rows. So over here, I have total data of 1202. So I'm entering this, pressing enter, and it has taken all the data which was there in my Excel sheet. With this, we're going to make the first data which is required. Now, over here, we have in bottom, you can see my cursor where it is. In the bottom left, we have one plus symbol with worksheet and the other symbol with dashboard. So first we have to create multiple sheets with different types of graphs, and then we'll select the dashboard. And over there, we'll make it. The first sheet which I'm going to make is based on gender. So I'll double click, it'll automatically take in rows. Since I want to prefer this in different two colors, I'll take drag from rows and put it in marks. Over here, we can see it is automatically taking in two square boxes, but I don't need in this particular format, I need it in pi. Now, because the name of gender is already given female and male, it has already taken two different colors. But since we have different values as well, we'll take number of records regarding this and put it into the detail size, measured number of records in angle. See. Now we have two different colors, and in the pi circle, it is dividing the angle with respect to the number of persons which are there. I'll show you the label and put gender again as a label so that we have female and male sum of numbers as well. As label, see, we both labels are there. Now, since you can see the pie chart, which was there in the sheet is very small in size. You can increase the size by adjusting here, or you can simply go at the center, put it an entire view. So it'll take in the center way. Now for change in color, we can go in edit color and select. And for here, three. See how beautiful it is coming. With this, one more key feature which is required. Sometimes people try and prefer to put, you know, boundaries showing a well-defined circle with a well-defined angle. So for this, you can go in circle. You can go to borders, select the automatic with a color black, or you can give any color you want. After this, the second preference with people is putting background colors. Over here, we can go to formats, we go to shading and change the background color into whatever color you prefer. I usually prefer a bit dark color so that you can, you know, soothe in my eyes while doing work. You can prefer light color as well, yellow, green, whichever you like. So we can see. Now for the titles, I have already hit. I can use it to bring it back. Sorry, excuse me. So since we are going to put it in the dashboard and it will be vibrant with the indicator over here, which is in email and mail. So we'll keep it in this way. We'll make one more sheet. And before going to that, we'll change the sheet name as gender. Go to the next sheet. We'll take domain. We'll again drag it to colors. Now it is already showing in this way. We'll make gender here and number of details. Circle. Color. So you can see the bar graph which I have created is showing with different domain names like business analyst, data scientist, database analyst, and programming language interest people. So over here you can see the sheet 2 title is given. If we want, we can give the sheet title, but since like I have already told that we are going to prefer to keep all these graphs in a dashboard and then give a headline which we have required. So we'll hide this one. We'll go to format, change the shading color, put it a bit dark. Go to this, change the alphabet colors to white. In the column, we'll again change the alphabet color to white. Keep this one. If we want, we can remove the lines from column and rows, but since it is reference line, we don't need this. We'll need like drop lines. We move the axis lines. I mean, sorry, we need the axis line, but we know X. That's it. See how beautifully the graph is coming. Now for the domain, like I've already said, it is better to keep a border. I'll keep a white border because the background is a bit dark color. Since you can see, I have created this graph in bar format. There are multiple variants which you can select from. I can see that some of the graphs are not able to visualize and we are not going to select it because this graph format which you have selected is not compatible to this one. So whichever is compatible, it is already shown in bit vibrant colors. Like you can see, the first one is text table, which can be selected. The second one is heat map, which can be selected. The third one is highlight table. This one is pie chart, bar graph, horizontal bar graph. So, but the others are not. And the last one is bubble chart. This one is also preferable, but since we want to keep in bar format and want to show the labels, that's why I'll keep this one. We'll change the name to domain. Now for the third sheet, we need states. We'll double click states. It is already showing different countries. Now, since you can see in the map, see the first question which arises with the people that after selecting the states, directly clicking, it will taking the longitude and latitude itself because it has inbuilt memory where all the longitude and latitudes of every states and countries already faded up. And because we have, you know, different country students who are, to see their data as well. So we want to filter it out, make it edit location. We'll only put fixed as India. And it will take only India. See, the other things have already vanished. So it is automatically showing circle. We'll go to field map, convert it into field map. And according to our data, we can select. Now we will take number of records, put it in color. We'll change the color pattern to more vibrant one so that we can see properly which color is coming. Now for this one, if we put on labels, we can see all the details of this. But at the same time, we need labels of this and number of records in this. So we can see that in marks, I have put in the colors of numbers and the number of students who are there in particular states in colors. At the same time, put the same number of students and labels so that I can see the color as well as the number. And I have taken states and put it in labels so that I can see the name of states as well. Now for this, I'll again hide the title, change the background color, the main sheet, and as well as the panel. Now the key difference with respect to these all, what I have already created in this map, is the panel color. We can adjust map in this way, increase the size and drag it as per our requirement and put it in a very competitive position. Right, beautiful. So over here, the key difference, you can see what I was talking about, that you have not seen any boundaries. But in this map, it is particularly showing boundaries. So when you put it in dashboard, it is going to look very different and put it in a different zone while presenting, and it look a bit awful. So keeping it clean, you should go to the border and make the panel none and headers none. Sheet panel none, header none. So you can see there is no boundaries right now. Now one more thing which we want to address. Now you can see the name of states which are there in the labels is showing a bit different color. And black with a black background is not vibrant enough. So we'll select some different color, more pitch dark or less, we can say, according to our suitableness, we can change the colors of background as well. See, okay, fine, black is fine. We'll change the name. Map. Now, since we have data collection of people who are interested into taking the course with respect to their own choice of month, the new sheet which we are going to select is month selected, the month they want to select. Over here, we have one limited data which we want to hide is this file. We have January to December. I'll take it in some of number in this. At the same time, I will take the same record, put it in color to give it in a variant colors. Now see, if I take the numbers, it will take a unilateral color and make it in different shapes according to the density of numbers. I'll show you. See, the bigger the number is, the highest of the number will be shown in the highest density of that particular color. You can see the blue color is very dense and dark when it is having the highest number of 168 students in the month of March. Now, if I remove this color from here and take it, drag it out, it will show the same color again, but with the labels. I'll take months and select and put in color. So it will select every month with it, his own individual colors. So it will looking much more nice and neat. Delete the sheet title, go to shading, change the color back to the common one. Now we'll go to line, make it sure that zero line is present. We'll go to alphabet, rows, select the color white, make it bit bigger and bold. We'll go to column, we'll change, we'll make it 11 and bit white. You can see the difference. Voila. It's looking clean and nice. Now for the lines, like I said, in rows, we sometimes don't need reference lines and the drop lines. So we try to remove it. That's it. See, the grid lines are gone. I don't need the axis sticks. See, the main difference you can see with the axis sticks is why it is not shown, is when you change and put it in black or white, you can see small, small bits of lines between the months is coming. So it depends upon your choice. I usually don't prefer it to put, so I try to avoid it and it make it clean. So this is what our fourth graph look like. So this one is month. We have one last graph to see. Mode. For this one, we'll take mode again in column and number of mode in this. And we'll again change it to pi or the line which we want. I'll take it angle. So we have taken pi and we have taken mode offline, pie chart, number details. We'll change the color for offline mode. For offline mode, dark this one, and for online mode, we'll put bit. We'll put the labels. Now see, because the labels are selected with the angle sum, so it is showing the numbers. To put the labels of the name as well of the mode, we'll put labels with mode as well as number. So we can see both online as well as offline. For the background color change, we'll go to shading again. See, in shading also, we have a row and a column where we select bar graphs. We can select the different colors with respect to them. But since we are making a circle or pie chart, we'll go to the main sheet, change it worksheet color to this according to our usage. We'll change automatically back and white. Select label bit bigger, 11 and bold. See how beautiful and nice and clean it is coming. We'll change this mode of selection, which is mode is sufficient. Now what we have created is gender, domain, map creation of people who are interested, month they have selected, and mode. Now if we want, we can make it more cleaner by, you know, for this month way, like these graphs are segregated in random ways, not in random, they are in specific order, but because the graph has having an even uneven number of increment in between. So to make in ascending or descending order, see the cursor where it is moving above and the top towards bit left from the center, we have ascending as well as descending order. So this one is descending as well as ascending. So we'll put this one, keeping the March as the bigger one, and it is gradually decreasing where the number of selection of students who are interested in taking in November is the least. Now we have created all these four and five charts. We'll go to the dashboard. We can see there are worksheets with their own specific names over here in the dashboard. The first thing we'll try to do is go in format, take the dashboard color, just defaulted this one because it will match with the sheets which we have created. Now, at the bottom of dashboard on the left side, we can see we have a choice of tiled and floating. And below that, we have a choice of show dashboard title. If we click this one, we can see two different boxes which are created. If we unclick this one, see the boxes are already gone. I check this one, we can see two different boxes with my mouse moving. So the first one is the title box where I can give the name. So we'll try to give it data management. No worries, it definitely taking color changes. Okay, fine, my bad. See, I'll put it in center, make it bold, and make it a bit smaller, it is too big. Fine. If you want, you can change the font as well and the styling of this, but I prefer to use to keep this the same way. Now I can in between go and the cursor is presentation mode, which is known as presentation mode. Over here, we have tiled and floating format. So usually people try to prefer doing through floating because when you drag any chart or the worksheet, it will come in this short format. And according to your needs or the design you want or the number of graphs you want to put in, you can, you know, define the shape. You can see there is a difference in color. We can go back to shades, change the color according to our need and come back to the dashboard. Voila. You can see both the colors, the background as well as the worksheet is matching now. Now to show you a clear picture, you can see that I can make big and small sizes of this floating worksheet. But if I put it in tiled, it will always come, see, in a parallel position where it will take the space of the sheet the dashboard and try to fill it, the remaining spaces, and it will take its own required space according to its own usage. So if you try to, you know, manually decrease or increase, the only thing it can do is go in lengthwise, either left or right. In any of the case, you go with any of the graph, it will go only left or right. So that is why we usually prefer to do it in floating mode. We are back. We'll check one more time. Go back to the sheet, put in this. Try to make it a bit bigger. Try to manage it, put into here. Check it. Back to the sheet. Now see, every time you select any worksheet, it usually gives the domain, the right side informations in the main dashboard as well. But since it is already present in the worksheet and it is already indicated in the graph, we don't need that, you know, take extra space in this particular graph sheet. See, this one what I'm talking about. Month selected, we already have these months written over here at the bottom of the bar graph. So it's better to take it off. Well, it depends upon person to person. If you want to show it and you have given some other names to prefer and your clients are going to say it in another way around, you can keep them as well. Now, since I can see this graph is taking a bit of long space and this is required much lesser with respect to this, I'll put this one in bottom. So this is what is the best, you know, advantage of doing floating. At the same time, having these three worksheets in the dashboard, I can you know, simultaneously move according to my choice and see whether it is fitting to the screen or not. I'll go a bit left, check it, it is too much. Again. So you can see we already have three graphs represented over here. Maybe I have one more map and mode. So first we'll prefer put the map and check whether it is coming properly or not. And according to our requirement, we'll increase the size. We'll go a bit up, corner wise, and see whether it is coming nicely or not. Correct. Take this one out. This up a bit to the right, make it clean. So guys, you can see when I have taken this one, the mode is coming. I'll just take down this mode out and try to see the full screen. You can see how nicely and clean it is coming. The reason I have taken this offline and online bit smaller than the main one, because you can see the male and female candidates which are required to see whether they have selected which course or not. The main reason is they are the students. They are the main priority who are going to select again into bifurcated into online or offline. So it's just a transition which I was trying to show that the main one is male and female, which are divided, and then again into offline and online sources, whether they have to select and interested in. After that, we have gone to months, which you have March as the highest month people are interested to enroll. And then there is November with the least number of enrollment interest. With the mode, we have now the domain which people wanted to get into. We'll increase the size of domain at bottom. Try to put it as clean and vibrant as possible. So this is going to be the end result. You can see in the one sheet itself, we have almost five graphs. You can insert more if you want. Pardon, I have to delete one more thing which would come in between. This domain part, which I've like said, the extra additive part, which is not required while showing into the dashboard. So guys, over here you can see, I have given a title of data management with five different form of worksheets with type chart of maps, two pie charts, one bar, and one mobile. The basic key structure of this Tableau is showing multiple worksheets into one dashboard and then sharing it with your end users. and get the multiple outputs regarding the interest the particular person or the end users want to. With this, I close this session and I thank you all for, I hope you like it. And with this, the one thing which I want to say is this platform provide you the intrinsic detail of every tiny specifications which you have already seen in the internet. But the key difference is the experts which are there in this DataGyan are highly experienced and already doing work in the corporate sector. So they have rich experience of 8 to 9 years in Dell and other corporate companies, which will give you a chance to, you know, do project and live sessions with exactly bang on points which are there present in the industry currently. With this, I end my session. Thank you all for watching and subscribe the channel.